Hey everybody, it's Lane here. I want to tell you in this video something that so many people are curious to know the answer of, and that is, how much does YouTube pay? Particularly, how much does YouTube pay per views or per ads that are shown? I want to show you in this video how much I made from one video that got about 160,000 views on a different channel. I'll take you inside of my analytics, show you a little bit of how everything works. I'll show you the exact amount that I made from that 160,000 views, how it all breaks down. I'll also show you how 160,000 views made a massive impact on that channel. It was really small, like only a few hundred subscribers. I saw so many subscribers come out of that, so much engagement, so much ad revenue. It was incredible. I want to talk all about it in this video, so stick around. I am Lane Sebring. I talk about self-publishing, personal development, and online business. Those are three topics that I love so much. If you're interested in self-publishing, definitely grab my five-step guide to writing a number one best-selling book, which I've done. My first book was a number one bestseller in its category on Amazon. And in this guide, I show you all the steps that I used to make that happen. So let's dive right in to see exactly how much 160,000 views can make you on YouTube. So before we dive into the analytics and I show you behind the scenes every detail about this video, I want to tell you a little bit about how it came to be, because this is important, especially if you run a small channel and you're trying to figure out, how do you make it come alive? How do you make it pop? And what I learned from this experience is that it really can come down to just one video. If you can get one video to take off, it can change everything about your channel. So basically, my channel that I'm referring to is another channel that I have here on YouTube called Preaching Donkey. It's a resource channel for preachers to help them communicate better and deliver better sermons. Most of the content on that channel is very straightforward, kind of here's how to preach better kind of content. But I decided to take an experiment, or to do an experiment, on whether or not a different kind of content might get some more attention, some more eyeballs, some more engagement. Because you have to know this, if you're trying to grow a YouTube channel, what you need more than anything is watch time and engagement. The more watch time you get, meaning that the longer people stay in a video and watch a video, and then the more that multiplies over different people and more views and more watch time, the more YouTube promotes the video in its algorithm to more people. The other thing is engagement. The more people that like, the more people that comment, the more people that share, the more people that subscribe as a result of watching that particular video, it just gets better and better and better from there. And so my channel, which had pretty limited engagement, was about 400 subscribers, not a ton of subscribers, but enough to kind of get going, but nowhere near the kind of goals and expectations that I had for the channel. As I got into this, I realized the power of making a video pop. Now, the first video I did was about a prominent preacher who was coming out and saying that he was changing some things about his theology. This was a big deal in this particular space, in this niche. So I just decided, hey, you know what? I'm gonna make a video giving my two cents on this issue, my commentary. And that video went nuts. It went crazy. What that first video did was it actually gave me the ability to even monetize my channel. Prior to that video, I was only at 400 subscribers, and you have to be at 1,000 subscribers, 4,000 hours of watch time over the last 365 days in order to monetize your channel anyway. So I wasn't even monetized, but this particular video about that prominent preacher ended up getting about 125,000 views, and then I did a follow-up video that got about 25,000 views. Well, guess what? All those views, about the 150,000 views, got me enough subscribers into my channel to get me over that 1,000 subscriber mark, and voila, I was able to turn monetization on, which was incredible. Couple months later, I decided to do it again. You can't just make these things happen, because you have to see kind of what's happening in your space and what's going on, what people are talking about. So I saw that another prominent preacher was having a little bit of a disagreement with another prominent preacher. And so if you're not in this space, it might sound kind of ridiculous, but these kind of things go on in every niche. So no matter what space you're in here on YouTube, there's going to be things to talk about. And we often think about trending topics as being these big things that everybody in the whole world knows about, right? It's in the news. The problem with that is it's so broad that it's hard to get attention on your channel if you're focused on this massive, massive story. What you want to do is focus on what's happening in your actual niche. You're going to be far more likely to be successful and to make something pop if it's specific to your niche. So that's what I did. I was like, hey, you know what? This worked last time. I'm going to go ahead and make a video giving my commentary. I'm going to show what each side said, what each person said, where they disagree, what I think about it. And that video went nuts. It was pretty polarizing, I will be honest. Polarizing content, by the way, on YouTube is really effective. It's not much fun to read through the comments because if you do polarizing content on a controversial topic in your niche, you are going to get comments from a lot of people that don't like you, that disagree with you, that want you to just go away. But what they don't realize is that every time they comment, that's more engagement, that's more watch time, that's more reason for YouTube to keep promoting the video, and that's what happened. So that video went just crazy, and I'm going to show you in the analytics, but it's gotten just about 160,000 views, lots of comments, lots of likes, lots of dislikes. Again, it's still engagement. It's still people responding. And what YouTube wants is they want people to stay on platform because that's how they make money. So if your video gets people to stay on platform and comment and like and dislike and share and say, gosh, isn't this guy an idiot? Look what he said. It's all good for you as the YouTube creator because it keeps people on platform and you get credit for that. By the time this video came out, I was already monetized, which was pretty awesome. And so I'm able to see this in this video, what 160,000 views does to a small channel that's already monetized. We're gonna see how much money it made, how many subscribers came as a result, and all that. So let's jump right into the analytics. All right, so this is the analytics of my channel, and this is the back end. This is what it looks like if you have never seen this before. So I've got 3,991 subscribers. Just keep that in mind as we talk about what this video did in terms of how many subscribers that it added. So if I go to channel analytics, this will bring up my analytics for the last 30 days or 28 days rather. So I'm gonna go to the video in question, which is right down here. And the video is called John MacArthur, Beth Moore, Go Home. And a couple things I wanna point out about this video before I go into the analytics is the title, John MacArthur, Beth Moore, Go Home, Beth Moore Responds, Lessons for Pastors. That title was really derived in part from the main like trending video that was going around on this particular issue that was happening. And I think that had a lot to do with the success because most of my views were from recommended videos. In other words, somebody watched a video and this video was what was recommended to watch next. I think that really helped me out. Let's go ahead and dive into it. So we'll go to analytics. You can see right here that since it published, it has gotten 158,400 views. So not quite 160, but close enough where I just rounded up. It's had 15,400 hours of watch time. It's brought 940 subscribers to my channel, which is pretty awesome if you consider the fact that it takes 1,000 subscribers to be monetized. So this one video took care of the majority of what it takes to be monetized. But again, by this point, the other video had already hit. And so I was already to a point where I had enough subscribers to be monetized, but this sure helped. So without any further ado, let's talk about money. So how much money did this video make? How much money did 158,400 views make? And it made $1,155.30. A couple things that I want to point out that are pretty exciting about this, and then we'll dive into that number more specifically. So $1,155.30 was made based on basically 90 minutes of work for me. I mean, I literally, from the amount of time it took me to do the research on what had happened, to pull up the videos to share in the video that I was making, what he said, what she said, the tweets about it, all that, to recording the actual video, to editing the video, tagging it, putting the description, putting the title, and uploading it, that whole process took about an hour and a half. So an hour and a half worth of work, and I've made $1,155.30. That's like pretty incredible. And if you've ever been curious, like, what does a video pay? What can a video pay? Well, 158,000 views in this case got me $1,155. Now, if we go to revenue, we can break that number down a little bit more. What is this playback-based CPM? Now, what this means is that CPM is cost per milli, or cost per 1,000. So it's cost per 1,000 views. So YouTube looks at it, and even though you're not actually paid based on view count, you're paid based on ads that are viewed. It's still, they make an estimate of how much that's going to be per 1,000 views. So at 156,600 views, it's paying about $13.21 per 1,000. And YouTube takes a cut of that, and they give me a cut of that. And so my estimated revenue is $1,155, like I said. Okay, so now I wanna show you the curve of views and the money that I made cumulatively. So the first day of kind of recording revenue, I made $8.01. The next day, I made $206.42 combined between the first day and the second day. So what that means is that the second day was $198, and then the first day was $8. So $198, almost a $200 day. That was the biggest day, I'm pretty sure. We'll see here in a second. But I'm pretty sure that was the biggest day this had. So almost a $200 day from one video that took me 90 minutes to load, just because of a lot of views and a lot of a high CPM and a lot of people clicking on ads. Okay, so it goes on, and let's see, day three, 358. So again, about $150 day, because this is cumulative. Day four goes up to 484, and then 571. And you start to see that how much money is added every day drops a little bit. You know, it goes 484 and then 570. So that's about, you know, $90. And then it goes to 650. So that's about $80. And then it goes to 714, so that's about $65. So it's reducing day by day until it starts to just get thinner and thinner and thinner, as you see the views getting a little bit thinner and thinner and thinner. So in the first, let's say 30 days, so by 30 days, I made $1,000 in the first 30 days, $1,010.70. So if you think about it that way, 90 minutes of work, 1 month, $1,000. That's not bad. So if people tell you you can't make money on YouTube, most of them have never really tried, or they've heard at least just one person say, oh, there's no money to be made. It really depends on CPM. It depends on how much advertisers are paying for your particular type of content. Some channels don't make a whole lot at all. Some channels are $2 or $3 per 1,000 views. In this case, $13.21 is what this video has averaged. I have no idea why. It has to do with who's watching the video, where they're watching it from, how much advertisers are willing to pay, because they're bidding and YouTube takes the highest price. So it could just be that I had some really high bids coming in at the exact right time and I jumped on it and my keywords matched up with what they were wanting and they paid a lot. Either way, it bought the camera that I am not using, not this camera, but the other camera earlier in this video and later in this video. This video paid for that camera and a tripod and a microphone and a few other things that I invested back in my channel. So that's pretty cool. Let's see, 31 by 30. Okay, so you see by 60 days, it only went up another about $65. So the first $1,000 in 30 days and then just $65 the next 30 days. So that just tells you that these things have a curve, you know, that they don't go into the stratosphere forever. This video, you know, this isn't a million or 2 million or 3 million. I would love to be able to tell you the data on one of those, but I've never had one. Hope too soon. Maybe this video will, and if it does, I'll do a video like this on this video, who knows. But the point is, you know, a month, 2 months, let's go ahead and check out 90 days. So 90 days, we're at 1094. So it still doesn't go up. Finally hit 1100 on day 101. And then of course, like I said, today is day 191. So this video has been out 6 months. It's made $1,155. And you know, every day it still makes, let's see, day 190 to 191, it went up just a few cents. We're down in the cents now. I want to show you another view This is actually views per day, which is actually kind of a neat view. So 23,222, that was that $200 day, the $198 day, 44,000, 75, 97, 109, 119. Let's see where the 30 days is. So 30 days got us to 138,972. And if you remember, that was $1,000, $1,010. So that's kind of interesting. So it keeps going from there, 147, 150. See, when we hit 150, it was 89 days. So right at about 90 days, 3 months, we hit 150,000. And then the next 3 months has got us to almost 160,000. Last thing I want to point out about this video is just how much engagement that it got and how, as I said, some of this is good, some of this is not good, but it all makes hay because it's engagement and that's what YouTube rewards. So again, 158,409 views, 1.8 thousand likes, 1.3 thousand dislikes. Okay, this is probably not the best ratio. Okay, this is a video that people have very strong opinions about, and I had a strong opinion about it. I shared my opinion, and so I just did not make a whole lot of friends with people who disagreed with me. So people who liked it really liked it. People who didn't like it really didn't like it, which, by the way, like I said, that's really what you want on YouTube. So 1,800 likes, 1,300 dislikes. That's a whole lot of engagement that was really good. And then 2,783 comments, almost 3,000 comments, which is just insane to think about that many people. That's quite a screenshot there, but it's insane thinking about that many people jumping on and having something to say about this video. So there you go. That's what it did. 158,400 views, $1,155.30. Brought 940 subscribers to my channel and got 15.4 thousand hours of watch time. So there you have it. It's pretty exciting when you think about YouTube and what's possible on this platform. Even for a small channel that relatively few people even knew about, it can really blow up fast. And so if you have questions, definitely leave a comment for me. I would love to answer your questions. Subscribe to this channel if you want more content like this. I would love to keep putting out content about YouTube, how to make a small channel grow. So if that's something that interests you, definitely let me know in the comments. Hit that like button. It really helps for the YouTube algorithm, and I will see you in the next video.